discuss the remaining question of exercise 1.1, standard 8, rational number, mathematics. Exercise you can do yourself very fast. Yes, here is your question number. And 4 also. Now look at 5. What the question number 5? Very simple one. Write or name the property under multiplication used in each of the following. So first one is minus 4 upon 1 multiplied by 1 is equal to 1 into minus 4 upon 5. That means gives minus 4 upon 5. Did you get any idea, student, here what you have to write? Very simple. What they tell us, minus 4 upon 5 multiplied by 1, it is equal to 1 into minus 4 upon 5. And final answer is minus 4 upon 5. What they did here, just they change the numbers. Suppose this is the first number and this is the second number. In second step, what they write? Second number first and first number second. So whenever you change the place to this one to this way, the multiplication, the answer remain the same only. So one is the multiplicative identity. Multiplicative identity means whenever we multiply with 1 to any number, we will get the same number in any order. Okay, students? Good. That's the identity of multiplicative. Second question, you can find minus 13 upon 17 multiplied by minus 2 upon 7. That means is equal to, they shifted this number to this number, student. See, this number and this number are shifted to here to there. See, first they wrote here 2 upon 7 and minus 13 upon 17. They change the place. So what the property used there in second question? Commutativity. What is there? Commutativity property of rational number. Okay. Now last one is multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse means here the you can see the ulta pulta. This is the 19 upon 29. Here 29 upon 19. So it's a multiplicative inverse. And multiplicative inverse always gives the answer 1. That's the second quality of this one. Okay, let's move for the next question. Here, what are telling us? Multiply 6 upon 13 by the reciprocal of 7 upon 16. Student, be careful. Here you are making mistake. When you find the reciprocal, what you did? You make it a ulta. Inverse, or you can say that like that. Reciprocal of this number. Of this number. See, I am writing here answer 6 upon 13, then after multiplication sign, and clearly writing here reciprocal of minus 7 upon 16. That means the number is become minus 16 upon 7. Did you find here, student? Yes. Now check out the number 6 into 16, which gives you a 96. And the denominator side 7 into 13, which gives you a 91. Easy. And don't forget to put the sign. That's a minus sign. Understood? Understood or not? Sign. Minus into plus. Minus. The table you remember. Rande Kapanda. Recurring question number 7. Tell what property allows you to complete this one. The question is here little big size. Which property we can use to solve this one? 1 upon 3 multiplied by 6 into 4 upon 3. As 1 upon 3 multiplied by 6 multiplied by 4 by 3. That's associativity property. Associativity property of rational number. How to solve this one? Associativity property. Okay, student? Good. So here associativity means there are three terms. We can take any group. Here is this one group. and here these numbers are in grouping. So don't afraid. Grouping means these three numbers are there. We can take two number, this one and third one common, separate. In second one, this second and third is taken together, and first is separate. Look at the question number 8. Number 8 is here very simple way. Is 8 upon 9 the multiplicative inverse of minus 1, 1 upon 8? Why or why not? We should have to check out. If it is the multiplicative inverse, then the product should be 1. Product should be 1. However, here the product is not 1. No, that's the product is not become a 1. So what we have to do, student? That's a minus 1 is the answer, because minus 1, 1 upon 8 will give us minus 9 upon 8, because 8 ones are 8 plus 1, that's a 9, and denominator remain as it is. So answer is here 8 upon 9 into minus 9 upon 8, which gives us minus 1. And we are knowing minus 1 is not equal to, this is the sign of not equal to 1. That's why it is a not a multiplicative inverse. Now look at is 0.3 the multiplicative inverse of 3, 1 upon 3. Why or why not? Let's check. We are knowing how to solve this one. 3, 1 upon 3 can write 10 upon 3. Once again, I want to show you, this is the last time. You have to multiply 3, 3 is 9, and then after add the numerator plus 1, 10. So 10 has to write on the numerator side, and whatever the denominator, it's remain the same. That's a 3. So 10 upon 3. Okay, now what does multiply this both number 0.3 and 3 upon 10 upon 3? Student, 0.3. Is it writing like this way? Yes, 3 upon 10, and multiply with this one 10 by 3. What will we do? 10, 10 cut, 3, 3 cut. Actually not cutting, each and every time we are writing 1. So 1 into 1, 1, denominator also 1 into 1, 1. Yes, so that's why the product is 1, and 0.3 is the multiplicative inverse of 3, 1 upon 3. Okay, good. Now look at here the next. The rational number that does not have a reciprocal. Rational number that does not have a reciprocal. Which number is that? Only 0 has no reciprocal, because I already taught in our introduction, any number divided by 0 is not possible. Understood, student? Yes, 0 is the rational number, but its reciprocal is not defined. The rational number that are equal to their reciprocals, which one is that? Yes, 1. 1's inverse is minus 1, and its reciprocal also 1. Okay, 1 and minus 1 also is there, are the rational number that are equal to their reciprocal. Last, the rational number that is equal to its negative. 0 has no negative, 0, 0 only. So 0 is the rational number that is equal to its negative. Look at the next question. Very easy question. Fill in the blanks. 0 has dash reciprocal. How many reciprocal 0 has? Not answer. No. Sorry, student. This is very important question for you. Second question. The number dash and dash are their own reciprocal. Yes, just now before while we discuss about this one. Once again, third, fill in the blanks. The reciprocal of minus 5 is dash. Yes, this one you have good idea. Try to write in your rough note. I will show you just now after 2 minutes. Now, fourth one, reciprocal of 1 upon x, where x is not equal to 0, is dashed. Student, this is the very easy question and revision of our wall exercise 1.1. That is the arc of exercise 1.1. Fifth, fill in the blanks. The product of two rational numbers is always a dash. What will come? I will give little hint for this question. When you multiply two number, what you will get? Yes, number only, but which type of number? Natural number, whole number, integer, or a rational number? Yes, you can find a rational number. Last question. The reciprocal of a positive rational number is dash. Student, here they ask us reciprocal. Let's check the answer. First one is a 0. Has reciprocal? No. No reciprocal for 0. Okay. Now what about the second one? The number dash and dash, their own reciprocal. Which one has we did? Yes. Yes. 1 and minus 1. Understood? So here first is no. No. Second one means 1 and minus 1. Third, reciprocal of minus 5. Reciprocal, when you are doing, don't change the sign. That will be a minus 5. That's a 1 upon minus 5. Yes, student. And reciprocal of 1 upon x, that means a x only. And the product of two rational number is always rational number and positive rational number. So just now I will write here. You can get little more idea about this one. Is a no reciprocal, 1 and minus 1. Here is the minus 1 upon 5. Good. And here is only x. This is the rational number. I will write here small rational number. You will get it here. What is this is? And this is the positive numbers only. Positive number. Understood, student? These are the answer of fill in the blanks. So student, this is very, very important question for you, for your exam base or for your further clarification. I hope so you understood all 11 questions clearly. You have to write this all 11 questions in your fair book without making any mistakes. Don't use the whitener. Question with black pen, answer with blue pen. Here I selected my pen as a red color because red colors answer you can find very easily. Understood? Very good. And now here we are concluding our exercise. Thank you. Have a good day. Take care. Be safe. Okay, bye bye. Okay, student. Once again, welcome to Chapri and Fatima English Medium School, Mahua. Today, we will discuss the remaining question of exercise 1.1, standard 8, rational number, mathematics. Exercise you can do yourself very fast. Yes, here is your question number. And 4 also. Now look at 5. What the question of 5? Very simple one. Write or name the property under multiplication used in each of the following. So first one is minus 4 upon 1 multiplied by 1 is equal to 1 into minus 4 upon 5. That means gives minus 4 upon 5. Did you get any idea, student, here what you have to write? Very simple. What they tell us? Minus 4 upon 5 multiply by 1, it is equal to 1 into minus 4 upon 5. And final answer is minus 4 upon 5. What they did here? Just they change the numbers. Suppose this is the first number and this is the second number. In second step, what they write? Second number first and first number second. So whenever you change the place to this one to this way, the multiplication, the answer remains same only. So one is the multiplicative identity. Multiplicative identity means whenever we multiply with 1 to any number, we will get the same number in any order. Okay, students? Good. That's the identity of multiplicative. Second question, you can find minus 13 upon 17 multiplied by minus 2 upon 7. That means is equal to, they shifted this number to this number, student. See, this number and this number are shifted to here to there. See, first they wrote here 2 upon 7 and minus 13 upon 17. They change the place. So what the property used there in second question? Commutativity. What is there? Commutativity property of rational number. Okay. Now last one is multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse means here the you can see the ulta pulta. This is the 19 upon 29, here 29 upon 19. So it's a multiplicative inverse, and multiplicative inverse always gives the answer 1. That's the second quality of this one. Okay, let's move for the next question. Here, what are telling us? Multiply 6 upon 13 by the reciprocal of 7 upon 16. Student, be careful. Here you are making mistake. When you find the reciprocal, what you did, you make it a ulta. Inverse, or you can say that like that. Reciprocal of this number. Of this number. See, I am writing here answer 6 upon 13, then after multiplication sign, and clearly writing here reciprocal of minus 7 upon 16. That means the number is become minus 16 upon 7. Did you find here, student? Yes. Now check out the number 6 into 16, which gives you a 96. And the denominator side 7 into 13, which gives you a 91. Easy. And don't forget to put the sign. That's a minus sign. Understood? Understood or not? Sign. Minus into plus. Minus. The table you remember, and a kapanda. Regarding question number 7. Tell what property allows you to complete this one. The question is here little big size. Which property we can use to solve this one? 1 upon 3 multiplied by 6 into 4 upon 3. As 1 upon 3 multiplied by 6 multiplied by 4 by 3. That's associativity property. Associativity property of rational number. How to solve this one? Associativity property. Okay, student? Good. So here associativity means there are three terms. We can take any group. Here is this one group, and here these numbers are in grouping. So don't afraid. Grouping means these three numbers are there. We can take two number, this one and third one common, separate. In second one, this second and third is taken together, and first is separate. Look at the question number 8. Number 8 is here very simple way. Is 8 upon 9 the multiplicative inverse of minus 1, 1 upon 8? Why or why not? We should have to check out. If it is the multiplicative inverse, then the product should be 1. Product should be 1. However, here the product is not 1. No, that's the product is not become a 1. So what we have to do, student? That's a minus 1 is the answer, because minus 1, 1 upon 8 will give us minus 9 upon 8, because 8 ones are 8 plus 1, that's a 9, and denominator remain as it is. So answer is here 8 upon 9 into minus 9 upon 8, which gives us minus 1. And we are knowing minus 1 is not equal to, this is the sign of not equal to 1. That's why it is not a multiplicative inverse. Now look at the is 0.3 the multiplicative inverse of 3 1 upon 3? Why or why not? Let's check. We are knowing how to solve this one. 3 1 upon 3 can write 10 upon 3. Once again, I want to show you, this is the last time. You have to multiply 3 3s are 9, and then after add the numerator plus 1, 10. So 10 has to write on the numerator side, and whatever the denominator, it's remain the same. That's a 3. So 10 upon 3. Okay, now what does multiply this both number 0.3 and 3 upon 10 upon 3? Student, 0.3. Is it writing like this way? Yes, 3 upon 10, and multiply with this one 10 by 3. What will we do? 10 10 cut, 3 3 cut. Actually not cutting, each and every time we are writing 1. So 1 into 1 1, denominator also 1 into 1 1. Yes, so that's why the product is 1, and 0.3 is the multiplicative inverse of 3 1 upon 3. Okay, good. Now look at here the next. The rational number that does not have a reciprocal. Rational number that does not have a reciprocal. Which number is that? Only 0 has no reciprocal, because I already taught in our introduction any number divided by 0 is not possible. Understood, student? Yes, 0 is the rational number, but its reciprocal is not defined. The rational number that are equal to their reciprocals, which one is that? Yes, 1. 1's inverse is minus 1, and its reciprocal also 1. Okay, 1 and minus 1 also is there, are the rational number that are equal to their reciprocal. Last, the rational number that is equal to its negative. 0 has no negative, 0, 0 only. So 0 is the rational number that is equal to its negative. Look at the next question. Very easy question. Fill in the blanks. 0 has dash reciprocal. How many reciprocal 0 has? Not answer. No. Sorry, student. This is very important question for you. Second question. The number dash and dash are their own reciprocal. Yes, just now before while we discuss about this one. Once again, third, fill in the blanks. The reciprocal of minus 5 is dash. Yes, this one you have good idea. Try to write in your rough note. I will show you just now after 2 minutes. Now, fourth one, reciprocal of 1 upon x, where x is not equal to 0, is dash. Student, this is the very easy question and revision of our wall exercise 1.1. That is the arc of exercise 1.1. Fifth, fill in the blanks. The product of two rational numbers is always a dash. What will come? I will give little hint for this question. When you multiply two number, what you will get? Yes, number only, but which type of number? Natural number, whole number, integer, or a rational number? Yes, you can find a rational number. Last question, the reciprocal of a positive rational number is dash. Student, here they ask us reciprocal. Let's check the answer. First one is a 0 has reciprocal. No reciprocal for 0. Okay, now what about the second one? The number dash and dash, their own reciprocal. Which one has we did? Yes, 1 and minus 1. Understood? So here first is no, second one means 1 and minus 1. Third, reciprocal of minus 5. Reciprocal, when you are doing, don't change the sign. That will be a minus 5. That's a 1 upon minus 5. Yes, student. And reciprocal of 1 upon x, that means a x only. And the product of two rational number is always rational number and positive rational number. So just now I will write here, you can get little more idea about this one. Is a no reciprocal, 1 and minus 1. Here is the minus 1 upon 5. Good. And here is only x. This is the rational number. I will write here small rational number. You will get it here. What is this is? And this is the positive numbers only. Positive number. Understood, student? These are the answer of fill in the blanks. So student, this is very, very important question for you, for your exam base or for your further clarification. I hope so. You understood all 11 questions clearly. You have to write this all 11 questions in your fair book without making any mistakes. Don't use the whitener. Question with black pen, answer with blue pen. Here I selected my pen as a red color because red color's answer you can find very easily. Understood? Very good. And now here we are concluding our exercise. One. Thank you. Have a good day. Take care. Be safe. Okay, bye bye.